All right, so let's quickly go through the details about, you know, how to begin with your classes and about our lectures and everything so that we can quickly start studying now. So about our lectures, the process, so how do you go about enrolling and all of that, technical requirements in terms of laptop, etc. What you need apart from classes is going to be your Schweizer book. So Schweizer textbooks is going to be required, four or five textbooks depending on which level, which exam you're taking. Calculator, Texas Instrument, BA2+. There are two versions, BA2+ or BA2+ Professional. The details will be provided. I'll give you all the contact details towards the end of the session, and you can ask the coordinator all the details and she'll give it to you. And of course, you'll have to enroll with the institute yourself. You can, you'll get the details as to how to enroll and all that, but you'll have to enroll with the CFA or FRM institute yourself, and then you get access to the online resources by the institute. So that is going to be done by yourself. Everything else is going to be taken care of at our end. And what is included in your pen drive when you get the lectures delivered, etc. So we'll discuss all of that, and how do we go ahead with your doubts and all of those things, how is it managed, we'll be looking at all of that. So how do you start off with it? So first, you can watch this lecture. Basically, you're completing the first class, I believe. So the first class is there. Along with that, a couple of other chapters for almost all the levels have been uploaded on YouTube. For I think CFA level 1, FRM level 1, we have got more than 3-4 chapters or so uploaded. So you can go through that once you're comfortable, and then you can move towards registering. The registration link, I'll get it attached in this description thing below. So you can fill in your details, your name and mail ID and all of those things will be asked, and you can make your payment. And so when you, obviously you can use credit card, debit card, gateway and all that, because there are a lot of foreign students also, and also Indian students obviously, but foreign gateway something. So there are gateways for students outside India as well, or you can do your bank transfer, UPI and all of that. So whatever it is, so or whatever payment method you want, you can go ahead with that. After that, what happens is, once your payment is done, it takes a couple of days to process. Within the couple of days, what happens is, we create the user ID and password for your lectures, because you have to play the lectures on our software, and that is going to be provided to you. Along with that, Google Drive, all the lectures are uploaded on Google Drive, and those, that Google Drive lecture link is going to be provided to you, so you can download the lectures and you can start studying. If you have not completed the chapters on YouTube, you can start with the YouTube chapters first. So there are 2-3 chapters, whatever is provided on YouTube, you can start with that first, and then you can continue once your lectures are delivered to you. Right, so it takes about a couple of days. Whenever I'm talking about the number of days, it is working days. All right, so a couple of working days, and you'll be getting your user ID, password, Google Drive link, etc. will be provided to you. After that, what happens is, within another couple of days, so after 1 or 2 days, then another 1 or 2 days. So once you enroll, after within 3 working days or so, we generally dispatch the lecture. So we generally courier you the pen drives and the book and the practice book and all of that. So all that is going to be sent to you. Normally, depending on the location, it takes time. So normally, if it is within India, I think it takes about 4, 5, 6 days or so, 4 days, 5 days or so, up to 7 days. We'll not risk that. We provide you with the courier details and, you know, the tracking ID and all those things. And if it is out of India, and depending on which country it is, normally it takes about 7 days to reach your destination maximum. And then you have your lectures received, and once you have your lectures received, wherever you are in the world, and you can start with your classes. And just not to delay your lectures, and you know, you're starting your studying and all of that, that is the reason why we create the ID, password and all, and give you the Google Drive link at the very beginning, so that within a day or two you are able to start with your lectures, at least till the time the pen drives reach you. And once the pen drive is there, then it's absolutely fine. You do not have to download. So you can only download the first few lectures or so, which you intend to complete in the next few days. And the moment the pen drive is delivered, then you can absolutely use your start with your lectures. I'll give you all the details. Don't you worry about it. When you're looking at the lectures, now with respect to the technical details and all, so when you're looking at the lectures, Windows laptop, the lectures are going to be supported only on a Windows platform. But there are hundreds and hundreds of students who are using MacBook, and that can be played using parallel Windows. Now what happens is, a lot of students have asked me this question. The problem is that, you know, even when I was taking one of these exams, I think CFP was online proctoring. The exam software was specifically made for Windows, because MacBook iOS has a lot of restrictions with respect to security and all that. And you could be having issues if you're using an office laptop in terms of restrictions and all. So that you'll have to check. And there is some minimum RAM requirement, I think 4 GB and all that. So all those details, I'll give you all the office coordinator's number. She will answer all the student queries and all, she takes care of. You can ask her the exact details, or I'll probably get it written in the description box below also. So you can run on, basically you can play the lectures on laptop. We also have an app for playing the lectures separately. So there are two apps basically. One app is with your doubt forum and studying and class notes, etc. There is another app to play the lectures that can be played on Android phone and Android tablet. So it works on Android basically. There is no software right now that can play the lectures on iOS phones. And my personal opinion or recommendation to you would be, please do not use phones to do the classes unless and until it is absolutely necessary. Use your laptops because you need that screen. See, ultimately technology, I always say that, you know, technology is just an enabler. You cannot substitute teaching. Most of my classes I like to teach on with the whiteboard. Yeah, I know we've updated in terms of technology, in terms of the whiteboard and all, but I need that whiteboard. I need to write. You need to see me and the board together. There are certain topics where, you know, I might sit down and I might teach using a tablet or something, depending on what topic it is and why I'm doing that. But otherwise, it is always better if I want you to see the book and read with me, only in those cases. But when I'm making graphs and all that, I want the whiteboard over here. So again, I'm telling you, try to use your laptop because you need to be very attentive when you're doing the classes. I know students who tell me, I'm getting 10 minutes in commute, I want to study. It's aise padhai nahi hota. That is not how you study. See, when you're looking at some corporate training and all these things, 5 minute, 10 minute micro modules, nudgets, and God knows what people do. I don't appreciate all that when you're studying finance. You're studying good, important concepts, derivatives, portfolio, etc. You have to get into the mode of studying. You have to absolutely get absorbed in the studying. You're going from one graph to the other, deriving a formula, understanding the concept. So obviously you need to work, you need to study for a longer duration. See, when you're in the live class also, you'll have to study with me for 2.5-3 hours. So even if you're studying at home, it is just that you have your convenience in terms of time, location, etc. You have that accessibility, but that does not replace the importance and the respect that you need to have while you're studying. So please don't do all that. So my recommendation is to stick to this, but just in case, you know, you have, there are kids unfortunately who use 2 hours, 3 hours commute time is there and they want to use that. In that case, when you're using your phone and all that is fine, but then again, you know, writing notes and all that becomes difficult while doing the class. So but anyways, that is available to you. That is a option we have. So that is that. Second is, the installation has to be done because the lectures are going to be playing only on our software. It is not going to be playing on anything else. And while you are working with our software, as in when you are playing the lectures, parallelly all the other background functions, as in anything open in your computer or your laptop, is going to be shut down. In the sense that you will not be able to parallelly do email and Excel and Word and all that while doing the lectures. When you are doing, and that is a very good thing. Some students have a problem, working students, you know, that every program have to shut down. That is how you have to study. You have to shut down the entire world when you're concentrating and studying. I'm actually reading this book. I was reading this book, Deep Work by Cal Newport. I found it so extraordinarily interesting. I completed it in a very, very short span. And that's extremely, extremely important. So it's, again, I'm not recommending right now for those who are into nonfiction reading and working on yourself, improving yourself. It's a little, if you're into non-fiction reading like this, or if you've read quite a few books, then definitely it is a must read. It's an absolute must read. So anyway, so the installation, what happens is, you will have an installation guide. Simple steps, you click here, set up this, that, whatever, and you install it. If you still have a problem, there are two options. Either my registration person will call you on a video call and they'll see your computer screen and guide you through that, or they can simply get a remote access to your computer. So they can see your screen and they will just do the installation for you. So they will take AnyDesk or TeamViewer. So generally we work with AnyDesk. So they'll take that AnyDesk and they'll take access to your computer screen and they will do the installation for you. It will not be a problem. So and then you start your lectures and start studying, and you don't have to wait for the lectures to get delivered to you in order to start this, because the moment you have your user ID and password and you have Google Drive link to download the lectures, obviously you have to download the lectures yourself. I've seen students at times, they are unwilling to, they don't even know how to unzip a RAR file, RAR or a WinZip file. You can just right click and unzip and all. So please understand, and they'll help you. Even with that, they'll help you. With respect to the lectures, you need the internet to play the lectures. You don't need internet to download the lectures. Obviously, once you have the pen drives with you, once your lectures courier has reached you. So internet is required to play the lecture because they are decrypting. So we encrypt the classes and provide it to you so that there is no misuse of the lectures. The internet is going to be used to decrypt the lectures, and you'll be able to play the lectures. You can forward, backward, rewind and all that. There are 7 views per lecture. On an average, all the lectures are around 30-40 minutes. There could be a few lectures with 1 hour because I'm engrossed. That concept is such that I cannot afford to take a break in between. So there could be certain lectures like that. But on an average, you'd say a 40 minute would be the size, the duration of a lecture. And you have to study for at least 2-3 hours at a stretch. Remember that. Validity of the lectures is going to be till your exam date. So obviously you have to mention your exam date when you're enrolling, because you'll be in the corresponding WhatsApp group. So if you're enrolling for, let's say, May XYZ exam, so you'll have to register. When you're registering, when you register on our website, you'll have to mention that, because you'll be in, accordingly, you'll be in that particular WhatsApp group, and you will get guidance accordingly in terms of targets, what you need to complete for the month and all. I'll give you the details. And in case, say for example, if you have to defer the exam, in case you do not clear the exam, in case you do not attempt the exam, in that case you will have to provide the details to our technical team, to our coordinator, and she will extend the validity. So till the time, you have to, all you need to do, there is no validity in terms of like 2 years or 3 years or whatever, as many. So you have to give a proof of deferring the exam, that I have deferred the exam to so and so date. So the institute's deferral detail or your result you can give, and they will extend the validity. So that is not a problem. Till you pass the exam, you have access to the lectures and all. And in case any changes are there in the curriculum, any new chapters are added or anything, all that is provided by Google, on via Google Drive. And if there's any new notes are also given, that is going to be provided through the app. So a courier second time is not going to happen, but whatever is needed is going to be provided you through the app or through Google Drive and all. The lectures are only going to play through our software, nothing else. And it is going to be accessible only on one device. So you can't use the lectures on multiple devices, again, to prevent any misuse. So even with respect to one device, say for example, if your laptop stops working or you want to shift from a laptop to a mobile or something, those things can be taken care of. But you cannot shift every day or every now and then, and you cannot have simultaneously two devices used. So one time, one device is going to work. Even if you have to change your device, you have to ping the technical team and they will do the needful. And they will allow you to change from one device to the other. But daily you can't change. If your laptop has broken down or you're shifting to a new laptop or something, only then you can do that. The access will be provided to one device only. Now, when you have the lectures delivered, so in the pen drive, how do we go about with the lecture? How do I structure? I have my way of doing the lectures and I've seen it's working pretty well. So it's working very well. So exam mentoring, there is a folder exam mentoring. It is quite important. So the first class is also a part of exam mentoring folder, the one that you're doing, where we discuss, you know, the overview of the exam, how the exam structure is, what is the preparation material required, syllabus of the exam. Because if you do not know the syllabus at length, you will not be able to grasp the whole thing, because there will be a lot of interconnectedness as you move forward. And about our classes and also, everything is going to be provided to you at the beginning, so that you know where is what. I've seen students at times skip the first class and therefore they do not know where what is placed and what are the things you need to go through. I'll tell you all the things and you need to be very, very careful about it. So then there is a how to use the calculator. There is a 12 part series or something on how to use the calculator, all the functionalities and all. Obviously, level 1 students will find this more important. Level 2, level 3 students might only need to refer to those functions which they are not comfortable with or which they haven't practiced much. Then how to study and how to practice. So I've given a brief in this lecture series on YouTube with respect to how to go about with your studies and practice, but in a very detailed manner, how you should write notes, how you should study the chapter so as to retain the maximum amount of content and to make sure that you're not making errors in the exam. Because see, understand, we don't have 7-8 exams with 7-8 papers like in BCom or college or school levels and all, where 700-800 marks of paper is there. We have 100 marks of paper, 80 MCQs, 60 MCQs or whatever, and within that MCQ, every single MCQ, every single mistake is going to be extremely important. So from the entire range of chapters, 40, 50, 60 chapters in your curriculum, 80 chapters, whatever, depending on which exam, which level you're taking. So out of that many number of chapters, you know, you will have 60, 80 MCQs or whatever. And those 60, 80 MCQs, you will have to make sure that your accuracy level is very high. So in that case, how to study in each level, each exam will have its own way of studying, own way of preparation, own way of practice. So exactly how to go about it, how to make notes, everything is mentioned in how to study and how to practice lecture. And it's advisable, you may watch this lecture or you may attend this lecture maybe after completing maybe 1 or 2 chapters. For CFA level 1, FRM level 1. For other levels, you start with this chapter because you already have an idea as to how to, because you've seen the curriculum, you've seen what finances and how it is. So after you do a couple of chapters and then you attend this lecture. And then obviously once your curriculum is completed, then how do you revise the curriculum? And also depending on your situation, you're in a good state with your syllabus, bad state with your syllabus. So based on that, how do you need to revise? How do you take mock tests? So what mock tests, what number of mock tests, how to take the mock tests? So those things are there. Then how to attempt the exam? This is the most important lecture in the entire lectures that we have. So how to attempt the exam? It's not, there is no shortcut to success. I'm not saying that you study 10 days, you will pass. You study 15 days, you will pass. You do this short notebook and you will pass. Absolutely no. There is absolutely no shortcut to success. There is no shortcuts, and you have to study like a student. No matter what be your age, I get this question also very often. Most of the students are going to be above my age, are going to be elder to me. But every single student, even today I'm studying, I'm still studying, and I plan to study throughout my life. And it has to be like a good student. So attempting the exam, there is no shortcuts and tricks, but how to attempt the exam, in which order you should attempt the paper, what should be your speed, or how to make sure that the error rates are low, how to make guesswork in case a couple of questions you're not able to recollect and all. So all those things, a lot of things are there. It's almost half an hour, 40 minute kind of a lecture, 40, 45 minutes lecture. This is how to attempt exam, the most important lecture. Now the exams are online, so how to use the exam software. So a software demo, so that on the exam day you do not have any surprises. And if there's anything else I would feel like adding to this, to the exam mentoring folder, I would do that. So these are the lectures. They're generally short lectures, like calculator would be an hour and a half or so, but others would be around 40 minutes, 30 minutes, 20 minutes or so. And to guide you so that everybody is on the same page and everybody knows how to go about it. Then obviously comes your class lecture. So 40 chapters, 50 chapters, 80 chapters, depending on which level, which curriculum you're going through right now. So all the classes, basically what we do is every single chapter is going to be having a folder. Let's say chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3. So every chapter has a folder. Within the folder, there are lecture 1, lecture 2, lecture 3, lecture 4. Obviously, the names will be different. For example, time value of money, _1 time value of money, _2 time value of money, _3, _4, maybe time value of money, _practice. So that way you'll have 5, 6, 7, whatever number of lectures are required, 14, 15, whatever, depending on the topic, depending on the length of the chapter, the concept and all. So the lectures like derivatives would have like 17, 20 lectures also. So the lectures are going to be provided in each of the folders. So all chapters are separate folders, segregated into folders, and within each folders, all the lectures related to that chapter is provided. Along with that, I generally add an image which gives you the details of, you know, lecture 1 has got this subheading discussed, lecture 2 has got this subheading, so that in case you want to get back to any particular portion, you can just simply visit that particular lecture. You don't have to struggle to see between which lecture has got which portion. So let's say loan amortization is in lecture 6. So you can easily see lecture 6, loan amortization. Time value of money _6, loan amortization. So you attend the lecture 6 and you'll be able to revise that particular concept. Now we've already discussed, on an average it's going to be like 40 minutes. I would rather say 40 minutes on an average each of the lectures. Depending on your level, the duration of all the lectures are going to be different. So that you can take from the coordinator depending on which level, which exam you're taking. The lectures are going to be 100% covering the entire syllabus. There is not a single paragraph, there is not a single LOS that is going to be missed out in the lecture. Even if there is any changes, any new chapters added, all those are going to be provided to you. So the lectures are going to be 100% exhaustive. There is not a single LOS that will be missing. LOS as in any single subheading of the chapter that is going to be missed. No concept, no formula, nothing can be missed in the lectures. The live students attend the lectures over here. The video students, the home students attend the classes at home. Technology enables that. But other than that, the teaching has to be traditional. The studying has to be with a lot of focus, continuous long durations of studies in order to absorb the concepts of finance and all. It is live lecture, students attend over here, video lecture student attend at home. Obviously, if suppose there are certain students in Calcutta, in Kolkata, where I'm taking the live lectures, and they want to visit the classroom and attend live revision lecture or something, or maybe a few topics or something at times, they're more than welcome, depending on the schedule of the live classes. And the live lecture students also, say for example, if they want to continue studying the remaining, let's say they've attended first 30% of the chapters and they want to complete the rest of 70% because they're relocating or they've joined a job in different place or location or something, then they can take the remaining lectures on pen drive and they can study the rest of the chapters at home. So that is that. There are a lot of basic lectures also. For example, in level one, you have basics of accounts, because a lot of non-engineering, non-commerce students are getting into finance. And finance is not about accounts, as I had discussed earlier also. You have new subjects, derivatives, portfolio, corporate finance, they're all new subjects. But a little bit of accounting knowledge is required in a couple of places. So the very basics of accounts, class 11, 12, mathematics is also needed, index numbers, logarithm, again, you don't, even if you've not studied logarithm, it is fine. Just that a few concepts of class 11, 12, maybe a coordinate geometry when I'm doing regression. So I try to revise a little bit of concepts over here and there. So time value of money, for example, is not a part of syllabus of FRM, but it is required. So whatever basic lectures or concepts are going to be required, all those are provided. Not much here. The language of the lectures is primarily English. So it is going to be around 70-80% of the lectures is English, but it becomes conversational, so it's English plus Hindi. So when you're looking at the class lectures, it is bilingual, English plus Hindi. If you do not understand Hindi, you will not be able to understand all the chapters and do the classes. So you have to be comfortable with English and Hindi to study with me. That is the situation right now. Yes, I'll be moving towards full English lectures also in the near future, but right now the lectures are full English plus Hindi. It's only the Excel lectures and all that is in full English, or investment banking lectures, equity research module and all, that is in full English. But other than that, when you're looking at the CFA FRM classes, they are bilingual, so you have to be comfortable with English and Hindi in order to do the lectures, right? So there is a, I've already discussed, all the chapters have a single one folder. In the folder, all the lectures of that particular chapter are provided, and I have put an image. Some chapters it's pending anyways. By the time you do this lecture, the images will be taken care of, and I'll tell you about the lecture guide, so that will anyways cover this whole thing. So the details of every single lecture is provided in that. Then there are practice lectures. Practice lectures is primarily in CFA level 1 and FRM level 1. FRM level 1, all the practice classes, almost all the chapters, practice lectures are available, because the level of difficulty of questions is quite a few notches higher. When you're looking at CFA level 1 also, we do practice with, say for example, there's a lecture on practice on p-value, continuous rate, compound interest, loan amortization, discount rates. So wherever, whatever extra practice is required, practice lectures is provided. Level 3 also, you have to attempt essay type questions, so practice lectures are there. So CFA level 1, FRM level 1 will have more practice lectures. As you move up the level, the lectures are not going to be needed so much, although there are lectures, but we have, like for example, FRM level 2, we have a lot of solutions of the practice questions provided to you separately also in the app. I'll discuss about the practice solutions and questions and all. So practice lectures are there. Then you have revision lectures. Revision lectures covers generally almost all the all the chapters and all. At times, you know, with the syllabus changes and all, a couple of chapters which may be very, very basic theory or something, in that case it might be skipped. Otherwise, revision lectures are there, and that is to go through the curriculum quickly before the exam basically. And then there is your formula lecture. So all the formulas across the chapters consolidated together, so that the retention in terms of learning formulas and all improves. So formula lectures covering all the formulas of the entire syllabus, that is covered in your formula lectures. Then you have practice books. So for each of the levels, different different volume of practice and practice books and all are provided. Like for CFA, again, you have for level 1, 2, you have two practice books, one clusters book, one practice book. Level 3 has one practice book. FRM level 1 and 2, you'll have two practice books each. Mind map book, which is like a summary of the chapter, and that is for some chapters. In case of a couple of chapters, it might be missing because a new chapter has been added. So when the new chapter is released, it is going to be given to your added to your app. So I'll explain the app part also. So you have the mind map book, which is like a summary, flowchart summary of all the chapters provided to you. Class notes, basically there are certain topics like ethics or maybe certain chapters which I've taught without referring to the Schweizer book. So in that case, and if I'm referring to any material like ethics is there, or code of conduct is there, ethics is there in CFA and FRM both. And we have, so you have the prints of those chapters. So those chapters together is your class notes. So depending on which chapters I'm going to do without referring to the textbook, without referring to Schweizer books. So class notes, if any is required, is that is going to be provided over here. In case I've done some questions and I wanted to give you a list of questions separately, which I'm discussing in class. So there is a bunch of notes over here that is provided. May not be relevant. So for example, FRM level 2 or CFA level 3. No, CFA level 3, one chapter is there. FRM level 2, most of the chapters are taken care of from the textbooks itself, from the Schweizer book. So there will be no class notes of chapter that way. Other than that, if there's anything extra that I want to provide, will be there. So, and obviously I'll be making you write also during the classes, not that I'll be making you write the entire chapter notes, because you are referring to textbooks and all, but you have to scribble in the margin, because I want you to write, you know, so something increased, let's say interest went up, so interest arrow up, therefore this went down, then this went up, so short notes. So I like you to write, because in my way, if I want to make you write a small table or something, so that is there in the class, so that all you can write in the margin when I'm teaching. So say for example you are discussing an example, or I give you a question to solve in the class and all, obviously, so that all you type, you write while studying with me during the class. Then you have, so basically I've compiled all of these things together into one Excel, and I'll provide it to you in print also. So there is the order of study. Basically there is a very logical way in which you have to study, in terms of which chapter will be first, second, third, fourth. So you can't do chapter 1, then chapter 2, then chapter 3. This has to this will change, because I try to alternate theory practical chapter, try to keep those chapters which have retention issues towards the end. So there is an order of study. So you will have, let's say, chapter 14 first, then 15 16 17, then we start with 30 31 32. So that order of study will be provided. Each of the chapters, I'll tell you that, you know, what is the difficulty level, whether the chapter is confusing or not, what amount of practice is required from each chapter, because obviously everybody could be in a different situation with respect to, you know, the lack of time, working professionals, students also with college responsibilities and all. So this chapter, a lot of practice is important. You get a lot of quite confusing questions. This chapter, you may skip practice. So I'll tell you about the chapter, difficulty level, confusing and all. And there's a performance tracker, so you can keep on tracking. It's an Excel tracker. You can just mark that these are the chapters done, and it will tell you that these many days are left, and this is how you need to, these many chapters you need to cover, this much time you need to study per week. So it will give you all those details. So this also I'm upgrading, and I've improved it very, very significantly. So earlier these used to be separate, and I've put together all of these things into one file. I'll show it to you, and you'll be using that. And then there is a lecture guide I'm working. Again, by the time you attend this lecture and you start, since I'm already working on it, so you'll have a lecture guide for all the levels and all. So in lecture guide, what happens is every single lecture. So if, say, for example, there are 50 chapters, each chapter on an average has got 4 lectures, let's say. So 15 to 4, there are 200 lectures, 200 videos, 200 lectures. So the lecture guide will tell you, you need to study these two lectures first. Then you have the how to study lecture. Then you do two more lectures. Then you study how to practice lecture. Then these two lectures. So it will give you an exact lecture by lecture outline, that this is the first lecture you need to attend, this lecture has got this content covered, and wherever I need to put any remarks that, you know, in this lecture please remember to do this, in this lecture this topic is very important. So I will give my commentary for every single lecture alongside. So that is what I'm making, so you'll get it very soon. So that is a lecture guide. So if you have 200 lectures provided, all the lectures that is provided to you, every single lecture is going to be mentioned over here, even the revision lecture. So you know exactly how to move, lecture by lecture it is going to be written. And then you can also, once you mark that done or something, once you just keep on, or you don't have to mark in the lecture guide, you don't have to mark, sorry. So once you see, you can track that if I'm at lecture 100, then these many hours I have completed, these many hours are left. So you can keep a track as to your progress with the lecture guide also. So I'll give it to you, I'll show it to you, you'll understand basically in which order you need to study, to evaluate how much you have completed, how much is left. Which chapter is more important, how to practice each chapter, in which chapter what term is important, which lecture covers what, all those details are provided. So you have a lecture by lecture, every single lecture you'll be guided throughout. I'm really happy about this thing, it's going to be very helpful. Then with respect to the doubts, so this is what is going to be provided to you when you are receiving the classes and all. How do you go about the doubts? So there is a WhatsApp group created. In the WhatsApp group, be very attentive and listen to me very carefully. So in the WhatsApp group, all the students are added. There are different section A, section B, etc. In the WhatsApp group, you people can post your doubts and queries and all, and you can solve each other's doubts. It helps you to, I've seen people becoming friends, networking, if you can call it, and you know, your concepts improve. Because one thing is very important, which I'm seeing lacking in most of the kids nowadays, the ability to explain. That is very important. It's not that I'm a teacher, therefore I have to be able to explain, and you don't need it. When you're working in team, when you're working with juniors, seniors, etc., the ability to explain, the ability to comprehend is very important. And also when you explain somebody something, then your concepts get even better. So be very, very active and solve each other's doubts other than your classroom related classes, your chapter related questions, concepts, etc. No other doubt can be posted in the WhatsApp group. We're very strict about it because others cannot be disturbed. So your college Google forms or any jokes and all that, nothing at all. You're strictly supposed to be discussing your questions, your exam related, your curriculum related questions, concepts and all that, you do. Other than that, there is an app provided. So that app is separate. Your classes that are played, if somebody is playing the lectures on the phone, that is a separate app. This app is there on Android and iOS both. In this app, there is a doubt forum where you can post your doubts and all. I have personally seen, you know, students ultimately do most of their doubts on WhatsApp group only. So, and the second is, in the app, a lot of questions. So say, for example, what happens is, I'll tell you this part. So you will get a fixed timing in which you can call me for your, not call me, you can WhatsApp me your doubts. So what happens is you send me your doubts. Let's say, for example, Sunday morning, 9 o'clock to 12 o'clock, I've kept a time frame, 10 o'clock to 10:30, one batch, 10:30 to 11, you WhatsApp me your doubts. Whatever your doubts are, whatever doubts you have, you WhatsApp. Once your doubts are WhatsApp, I'll solve the doubt either on pen and paper, send it to you, or on a video, or on audio note or something. Whatever it is, your doubt will be taken care of. And I take maybe a couple of days if the doubts are piling up, or if I'm occupied on a Sunday or something, but I'll keep a fixed time. So Sunday you've sent me the doubt between, let's say, 9 o'clock and 12 o'clock, Monday, Tuesday, within Monday, Tuesday, generally, I'll be solving all your doubts, sending it to you on WhatsApp. And in case I skip maybe a doubt or two, then next doubt session, you can again ask me. And if I'm not able to solve the doubt on WhatsApp, then I'll call you up and I'll do the solution with you. And other than that, now what happens is, because of this reason, because of this process, what happens is all the difficult questions, good questions that come to me, confusing concept that, you know, student is getting confused between real rate, real risk-free rate and real nominal rate. There were some two rates student was getting confused between 3-4 terms. So I make an audio note, or I'll make an image, I'll make a very nice explanation. And what I do is I send that doubt to that student and I also add it in this app under the respective chapter. So what happens is all the difficult questions, confusing points, even if I'm explaining one paragraph which is confusing and I think it is relevant, as in it is not a personal doubt, but other students could also have it, I put it all under the respective chapters in the app. So in the app also, you'll be getting an access to the app. So when you register, when you enroll, you have access to not only the lectures, you'll also be getting an ID password for the app. So you can use the app on Android or iOS, or you can also have a web login. I'll give you the login thing also. So in that, every single chapter name is mentioned. Within the chapter, all the difficult questions, answers, whatever I have solved for any of the student, I add it and I keep on adding it. So every doubt session, after every doubt session, there are more doubts which are going to get added to that app. So you can get access to all the other students' doubts. And obviously, before you ping me for any doubts, try to sort it out on WhatsApp. And not important, but what you need to do is make sure that all the difficult questions and the explanations in the app has already been completed. Because most of the questions in the app will always be the confusing ones and the difficult ones. Once that is done, most of your doubts will anyways be clarified. If anything remaining, then I'm always there. Right? Always there in the given timings and all. Then there is a monthly update that we do. So monthly update is basically at the end of the month, I ask in every single group that students need to post how many chapters they've completed, what level of practice they've done. I analyze all the multiple groups together and all the students together. And then based on that, I give you an idea that, you know, based on your colleagues, based on your classmates, this is where you stand. This is on an average what people have completed. If you've completed so and so chapters, then next month, this is how you need to behave in terms of studies. If you have completed this much, then this is how you need to go about. So and any update that is there, anything that is required, all that is provided to you in the monthly update. So there is a monthly every month. At the end of the month, everybody needs to share their progress in the group. Only at that time and based on in the group, right? And so everybody can see and you don't have to worry about who's thinking what and all. Please, obviously, it's not, we're not children. So, and based on that, I analyze across the groups and give you that detail. Other than that, there is a lot of mentoring, I believe, is obviously required in order to go through with the curriculum and all that. So there are questions, you know, students ask me questions about how do I improve my focus, how do I retain. So I've got a lot of mentor notes, maybe an audio or a video or something that is provided. So how to focus, how to retain, how to manage your energy in order to be productive. This is there on YouTube also. How to manage studies with a full-time job. This is also there on YouTube. How to read then, and along with that, not just classes related, not just curriculum related, but beyond that also you need to read. See, you can get your degree, you can get your designation, but you have to be able to apply that knowledge in order to grow in your career. So you have to read. So how to read? In fact, there is a way of reading also. So if I'm reading a lot of nonfiction, there has to be a way, because what I read 3 years back, I don't remember today. So I have to underline, I have to write few bits and pieces over there so that I can revisit that book in a 5, 10 minute, 20 minute time frame and make sure that am I applying those things that I read 2 years back. So how to read is also there on YouTube, productivity, etc. Then there is a lot of things with respect, you know, mock tests and also even when you take your mock test, there is a mock analysis that is done. So once you take your mock tests at home, so mock tests generally for CFA, definitely we stick to the institute papers, even for FRM, the institute has ample resources. So in the study material resources lecture, I've already discussed all this part, but mock tests again, the analysis has to be done. So once you take your mock test, we guide you exactly how to take the mock test and all. Once your mock test is over, you're supposed to be filling in a Google form or something we send to you. And based on that analysis, I again guide you that, you know, your mistakes, if it is more of silly mistakes you're doing, then how do you need to go about it? So that analysis has to be done. That analysis is sent after your mock test is done. Even the previous year's mock test analysis and all is provided. So that you know that what mistakes people are doing and how do I need to approach as we move towards the exam. Result analysis is also done. Like for example, this particular subject students are making more mistakes. So they are getting poor scores in this particular subject out of the 10 subjects, out of the 5 subjects. So work harder on this subject. So that all that analysis of the past year results, mock papers, etc. is also provided. All these things are going to be given in your app, this mock analysis and all. And even the monthly update and all that, we send it to you on WhatsApp. And there is a notice board in app, in your app. So in the notice board, whatever we are providing on WhatsApp also is going to be provided and sent to you on that notice board. With respect to guidance, so say for example, a lot of frequent questions come to me from the students, like what should be my strike rate, what is the difficulty level, so comparing the difficulty level of different study resources and questions, because they want to understand what is the difficulty level of exam and the resources they have, how to get a scholarship, let's say with the CFA Institute provides quite a few, then how to get a charter, what time to choose for registering for the exam, so should I choose a morning slot, afternoon slot or what, when I'm registering for my computer based exam, dependencies of chapter, which chapter depends on level 1, so which chapters of level 1 for example is relevant for level 2, so you need to focus on that, so that list of dependencies, if you're starting a little last moment then how do you plan your studies and all. So variety of questions I get, keep on getting questions from the students and all these answers are made and all, so that you have absolutely all the everything taken care of. Another thing, application, what I do is I'll just give you a simple example. Suppose in CFA level 2 there is a term called hyperinflation. So now when we are studying hyperinflation, I want you to be able to apply your knowledge as well. So there is a there was a small 3-4 minute YouTube video on how Venezuela faced hyperinflation despite being the most rich country in terms of resources, oil, minerals, etc. And how did it how the currency absolutely lost its value. So that 2-3 minute YouTube video I'll put in under that hyperinflation related chapter. So with that particular multinational operation chapter, I'll put that hyperinflation YouTube link. Or if there is any report, equity report that I have, or if I have a risk report or something, if I want you to go through something, application, you can choose to do that, you can choose to ignore. But obviously you need to learn how to apply. So regular basis, I keep on adding this. Also, we have the monthly newsletter and all from my consulting company, Leveraged Growth. So applications, I would also like to add over here, LG blog. So every month we have our monthly newsletter, which has got markets and equity and sectoral update, macroeconomic, government policy, startup news, strategy related, etc. So just check that. I'll just give you over here. I'm actually very happy about it. My team does an amazing work over here. Leveraged ED Growth dot in. Do make it a point to visit the blog section and read. There is immense amount of coverage and there is a monthly snapshot we provide. So that is there, and along with that the application part, as I told you. So a good article online or something of that sort which is relevant to a particular chapter. So within that particular chapter, under that particular chapter, we put that. You can access this app also, as I told you. So the app is in my name, Ashwini Bajaj. You just need to spell my name correctly, A-S-W-I-N-I Bajaj. It's on Android and iOS both. Or you can also visit the website students.ashwinibajaj.com. And you have a course I've made, Invest in Yourself. So we trademarked this and we are doing something really nice about the Invest in Yourself. And I truly believe in that. So you can check that there is an Invest in Yourself kind of a course made, not a course exactly, but all the resources put together, a lot of career related questions answered, a lot of good links and book summaries, etc. that has been placed over here. And I'm working on something very interesting in IIS core. I'll tell you about it once I am able to find time and get that put up in this app. But amazing things happening. So there is a free version of this app also with limited access to limited things available. So you can check over here, see FA level 1, 2, 3, FRM level 1, 2, etc. Everything is there. There is a free version, non-free version. So basically a version where you can just see and how the platform looks like. Lectures are not played on this app, but a full version of app access you'll be provided once you are done with your registration and all that. Once you get your user ID password to play the lectures, you'll get the ID password for this as well. This works on iOS and Android both. The lectures don't. Playing the lectures, Windows, parallel Windows on Mac or Android phones and tablets. Placement assistance, I don't like to talk much about it because again, there are people who say 100% placement assistance. That is just kind of misguiding. We assist, basically, we have a lot of students in different banks, in different fund houses, brokerage houses, etc. And whenever they have requirement, they also tell us. We are associated with a lot of HRs also. And those students who are interested, they can fill a job form or something that we have a Google form with the details. And whenever there's an opening or something, we recommend, we push and all that. But again, I think I should rather remove this part because I don't want to misconstrue anything. And you work hard, you study hard, you learn how to apply your reading skill, reading, writing skills, Excel, technical communication skills, etc. You improve yourself, you're automatically going to do very, very well. So anyway, so that is something that I have started, I want to do and I'm doing and I'm actually happy about it. But anyway, so placement assistance. Achha, next comes your support and contacts and all. So how it goes about is that, you know, when you if you have any questions with respect to before enrolling the for the lectures and all, you can have the information over here, 9831149876. Everybody has to put a plus 91, that is country code, 9831149876 for all the information and all. So that is the coordinator for all the inquiries and all. Once you are enrolled, what happens is once you register, the notifications number, this is the number who's going to be messaging you your user ID, password, any message that I need to send to the students, adding you to the WhatsApp group, all broadcasting any information from my side, all that is taken care of by notification. So she is going to take care of all the notification, also video calling you or taking any desk access, remote access to do the installation and all that, and providing you from time to time all the information from my end. So if you have any questions, you can't ask her. She will give you all the details, your tracking ID, courier detail, etc. If you have any issues, so this is your, after enrolling, any issues, you reach out to the coordinator over here. And if there is any technical problem in terms of you need to increase the view, you need to increase the validity, or you have your lecture is not working, say for example, or your ID password is not working. I've seen students put the wrong ID password again and again and get irritated and all. So all those things also happen. So then you reach out to the technical desk. And in all probability, try to WhatsApp them. If you want, you can call them, but my recommendation would be WhatsApp them. So because it's easier, because one, it is written on record and they have most of the answers, all the answers made by me. So if there's any question, you know, say for example, if I want to know the scholarship detail, you ping her the scholarship detail, any of these people, and they will give you the details about scholarship. So whatever question you have, most of the answers are made and they will provide you with all the guidance. In case anybody is not resolved your query within one working day, after that one working day, you WhatsApp me. My number is there with every single student of mine. Every single student of mine has got my number. And do not call me because I'm in the class or something or the other and my phone is anyways always on silent. Just leave a WhatsApp and leave a WhatsApp with a screenshot that you had reached out and your query is not resolved within one working day. After that, you ping me. Before that, please don't do that because, you know, I'm also in the class. I'm studying all the time. I'm taking classes, taking lectures all the time. So it gets very difficult and I've made all the answers. If they're not able to solve a question, they will get a new answer made from my side and then they will provide it to you. So don't worry about it. And other than that, for the doubt session also, there are students at times I've seen who get a little impatient that I'm studying right now and I need the doubt resolved right now. See, we are not going to be Ola, Uber, Swiggy and Amazon customer care and all. So I teach, I'm a teacher, you'll have to respect me and my time and my office also. So, and also I've seen students at times, you know, they did not answer a call and within 5 minutes they are messaging me that your coordinator is not answering the call and it's not urgent. We are not doctors or something that things are very urgent over here. You leave a WhatsApp, they'll get back to you. They're reaching out to so many students. They could be on lunch break during working hours within one working day. Every single issue is going to be resolved. I'm saying one working day, but within, if there are two less chats, then obviously immediately they will answer your query. If there is a lot of backlog. For example, Monday morning, they are going to be late. Why? Because Sunday, all the chats of Sunday are taken care of on Monday morning. So Monday, so all the chats of Saturday evening, Sunday and Monday morning is taken care of on Monday. We've also got technical team working on Sunday also now. Maybe one or two Sundays in a year or something, we might have a problem. But otherwise, the technical desk is working on Sundays also so that the working students do not have a problem if they get stuck or if they are, you know, having any technical query or technical issue in running the lecture on their laptops and all. So the technical desk will be there on Sunday also. So you don't have to worry about that. So technical desk works throughout 7 days. And if you are in a different time zone and all that, just request you to leave your WhatsApp and within the next day you'll get the reply. So always try to stick to WhatsApping the numbers and please make sure that you're pinging for relevant. So any new students, before enrolling you reach out over here, after enrolling all the issues you reach out over here, all technical issues and all technical queries and all you reach out over here. You're not able to find a note, a chapter, you're not able to find any problem you have, you reach out here first. Any query, scholarship, certificate, whatever problem it is, you reach out here before reaching out to me. And this is not to reach out for queries. She's going to be sharing information and messages from my end. So obviously, and she will, for example, the moment you register, she'll give you the phone numbers also to save in your WhatsApp. So she'll WhatsApp you all the phone numbers to save, all your tracking ID of your courier and everything, user ID, password, everything is going to be provided by her. So she's just sending messages on our behalf. And this is what it is, and I'm always there at the right time. So after one working day, if any issue is unresolved, you immediately WhatsApp me. Don't wait for 2 days. I've seen students, sir, I was not feeling like disturbing you, so I did not ping. But if you are losing out on your studying time and all, then it is my problem. So don't wait beyond one working day. Any issue unresolved within one working day, you ping me. But instant doubts and all, I will not take care of. So I've seen students at times, I'm studying right now, I'm stuck, please tell me one doubt. So that is not going to work. Because I have to study and I have to be disciplined. Read the book, deep work. You need long uninterrupted stretches of time to study. I have to study, I have to teach. So that is not going to happen. So I will not overpromise and underdeliver or misguide you on that. It is not possible that when you are studying, I'm available. It is not possible. There are hundreds of students studying at different hours in different cities and different countries across the world. I cannot be doing a real-time doubt solving. So please be, I'll be very, very honest over here, but your doubts will be taken care of. You will generally not have so many doubts after the lectures and all are done. And after the amount of information, so every month we are giving you an update. If there's anything new, we are providing it to you. If there is anything confusing that is there between in a chapter or something, we are putting it in the app anyways. So, and it is going to be always, you know, the material obviously in the app, or after every doubt session there is going to be more details and more questions and all added. So you'll not have a problem, I'm there, but you have to stick to your doubt session. And you have to stick, even a weekly timing is provided. The timing will be provided to you once you are there, that even if you have doubts with respect to students have confusion when, you know, I want to shift a job, do I do that or not, or I'm confused about a certain thing and I want a little guidance or something, then there is a particular time in the weekday at this point of time on this day you are allowed to send all your those kind of doubts, those beyond curriculum doubts also, where you need some mentoring or something from my side. So that is also there, I'm available for that. But you have to maintain that discipline and timing. I've seen students at times they'll say that, you know, I forget the doubts. So you note the doubt, you make a dummy WhatsApp group without anybody, you keep storing your doubts over there. After and at the exact time you'll have to send me the doubts. Even when I reach out to my mentors or somebody, I would have to, or if I'm reaching out to someone for advice, let's say. So there's this gentleman, he's retired right now, he was the HR head of a company, and I reach out to him every 6 months or so, and he gives me a time that 11 o'clock on this date you reach out. I put a calendar reminder so that I will not miss out that time frame. So I'm trying to, obviously there's way more scope for improvement every day, there's so much to improve. So I'm trying to be very strict with my routine, with my timing, and you'll also have to do that. And I'll keep guiding you. So I know I might be coming across as very, very strict and all. It is not like that during the classes. My students know that. But with respect to studying, because you'll have to be strict. Otherwise, how do you plan to crack an exam, learn finance, learn things? How do you plan to do that? You'll have to be strict. You'll have to be very routine, disciplined and all. Right? So you'll have to work. You'll have to understand these things. It's very important. So, and I'll be doing that. I'm not going to be sugarcoating. I'm a very blunt person that way. I don't sugarcoat. I'll not give you any shortcuts. There's no shortcut to success. There's no shortcut to cracking exams. You'll have to build your base very, very strong in order to study. There is no shortcuts and all. So understand that. I'm strict with the, I'll be strict. I'm anyways responsive. But within one working day, if an issue is not resolved, immediately WhatsApp me. You simply WhatsApp me, you send me the screenshot, this issue is not resolved, and I'll look into it. But yeah, other than that, I've already told you that any other career doubts also you have, we give you a particular time you can WhatsApp. So academic doubts, generally I keep a Saturday or a Sunday or something. And all you need to do is just WhatsApp me. And yeah, that's more or less about it, I think. I think I've become very strict with this lecture. I'm not that strict. So in the classes, we'll be cracking a lot of, not a lot of, it's not a stand-up. Anyways, forget it, sorry. So comfortable, understood how we go about with the classes and everything. So yeah, that's about it. All the very best. Study, study hard, start studying.